Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create this Google Ads dashboard in Google Data Studio. By creating your dashboard in Google Data Studio, you can choose which metrics to include, how data is presented, and even customize the look of your dashboard. We'll use two data sources to create this dashboard. We'll include data directly from Google Ads, and also include data from Google Analytics, so we can understand how people engage with our website after they've clicked our ads. And we'll be using the latest version of Google Analytics, which is Google Analytics 4 or GA4. However, if you're still using Universal Analytics, then you could connect this to your dashboard too. Okay, so we can see this dashboard focuses on two key areas when it comes to Google Ads campaigns. The first thing is that it has a strong focus on the advertising cost, so how much we're spending overall. For example, at the top we can see key metrics presented as scorecards. And then we can also see the cost broken down by the individual campaigns, as well as the devices people are using, again, based on the advertising cost. We've also compared this to conversions. So really, this Google Ads dashboard is focused on cost compared to the results we're achieving based on conversion data flowing through to our Google Ads account. This makes the dashboard very actionable because we can immediately see where we're spending and the results we're achieving. So this makes it easy to identify areas that we might want to improve in our account. For example, we can quickly see there are campaigns that haven't resulted in any conversions, and campaigns that have only resulted in a few conversions. And we can also see the cost associated with each campaign. So if a campaign is costing us and we're not seeing results, we can then head to our Google Ads account to analyze performance in more detail. Now, the dashboard does also include some data from Google Analytics. The purchase revenue is coming from Google Analytics 4, GA4. This metric shows revenue from e-commerce transactions being collected into the reports. And the engagement rate metric is also from GA4. This is a top-level health metric for the website and shows the percentage of engaged sessions. An engaged session is counted when someone spends longer than 10 seconds on your website, when their session includes a conversion, or when a session includes two or more page views. So assuming that your Google Ads campaigns are really geared towards driving people through to your landing pages and getting them to engage and convert, then you'd be looking to increase your engagement rate. At the bottom of the dashboard, we can also see some trend data. We are mapping out the data from Google Ads based on day. This gives us the overall trends for the cost. So if there's any particular peaks when we're spending more on a given day, as well as the conversions we're achieving on each of these days. Now, of course, we're going to travel through creating this particular dashboard, but I do encourage you to actually customize this to meet your own particular needs when it comes to managing and reporting on your Google Ads account. You might, for example, be more focused on different types of metrics. For example, if you have a content-only site, then you might want to switch out conversions for a different metric that is appropriate for your particular organization. Or if your site is focused on purchases, then you might want to change the engagement rate metric to average purchase revenue or purchase-to-view rate or another e-commerce metric. Now let's head to the Google Data Studio homepage to create this report. And let's click Create. Now I just want to highlight that you can connect your own Google Ads account as the data source, but for this dashboard we're going to use the Google Ads sample data. So let's select My Data Sources. And then we can select Sample Google Ads. This might be at the bottom of the list if you haven't used it before, and you can also use the input at the top to search for it. Now let's click Add and Add to Report. Now we can start building our dashboard. A table is added by default, but let's remove this so that we're starting from scratch. Let's add a scorecard to the top of our dashboard. And we can drag this to position it where we like. We can see that the sample data is immediately loaded from Google Ads, but again, I encourage you to connect your own Google Ads account to your dashboard. Now I'm going to click on the default metric to change this. Let's search for and select Cost. This will show us our advertising cost for all of our campaigns. I simplified the way the cost was presented in the final dashboard. To do this, let's select Style, and then enable Compact Numbers, and let's select 2 for the decimal precision. This just makes it a little bit cleaner when larger numbers are presented. Next, the final dashboard had a small trend line next to the metric, so let's add this by selecting Add a Chart, and then selecting the Sparkline Chart option. It's the one in the middle under Time Series. Since we just used the cost metric for our scorecard, we can see that the Sparkline chart is automatically using this metric. If the metric is different, then you can change it by selecting the current metric and changing it to cost. Before we add the other scorecards and trend lines to our dashboard, let's add a bit of styling. Let's add a rectangle. And move it behind our charts by selecting Arrange, then Order, and then Center Back. Let's adjust the size and the position of the charts. Now let's change the color of the rectangle to white. And add a corner radius. And add a border shadow. Now let's change the background color of our dashboard. To do this, let's select Theme and Layout. Then click Customize. And change the report background to gray. Now let's click and drag so that the two charts and the rectangle are selected. And let's choose Arrange, and then Group. Let's copy this so that we have this element repeated 6 times at the top of our dashboard. Now we need to adjust each of these to present the correct metric. Let's double-click Cost in the group on the very right to edit it. And let's change the metric to Conversions. You'll need to make sure that you have conversion tracking set up correctly inside Google Ads in order for conversions to be correctly reported. If you'd like to learn more about Google Ads conversion tracking, then I've included extra resources for you in the description below this video. Next, we need to double-click the Sparkline and change the metric to conversions. Now on the second row, let's double-click cost in the first group and let's change the metric to conversion rate. And then let's change the metric for the Sparkline. Then for our next group, let's change the metric to CTR so it shows us the click-through rate for our ads. And then let's change the metric for the Sparkline. Okay, now we're going to add metrics from Google Analytics, so let's double-click cost in the middle group of the top row. Then we need to click the current data source for the chart. And now let's click Add Data. Currently, Google doesn't have a sample GA4 Google Analytics data source in Google Data Studio, so I'm going to connect Google's demo property to this dashboard. You can do the same, or I actually recommend connecting the Google Analytics property for the website you're advertising with Google Ads. For my dashboard, I'm going to select Google Analytics, then Demo Account, then GA4 Google Merchandise Store. If you don't have access to this demo property, then I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial in the description below this video. Now let's click Add. And add to report. Now let's change the metric. Let's select the default metric and search for and select Purchase Revenue. This is an e-commerce metric, so if you're not selling on your website, then you could select another metric from Google Analytics. For example, you could use something like users or sessions or any other metric instead of purchase revenue. Now, the important thing to highlight here is that purchase revenue will be for the entire website, which means all the different channels that are driving traffic and resulting in purchases. So we're going to apply a filter so that this only includes traffic from Google Ads. To do this, we scroll to the bottom of the data column and we click Add a Filter. Let's name the filter Google Ads. Leave Include and then search for and select Session Source. Now let's select equal to as the condition and let's enter Google or lowercase as the value. Now let's click And. Leave Include, then search for and select Session Medium. Then equal to, and enter CPC, all lowercase, as the value. This will only match Google CPC, so our Google Ads traffic coming to the website. Now let's save the filter. We can see that the value for purchase revenue was updated to only include the value of e-commerce transactions associated with our Google Ads campaigns. Now let's select the sparkline. Change the data source. Ensure that purchase revenue is selected as the metric. And add the filter we just created to the chart. Now let's double-click the cost metric in the group on the bottom right. And let's change the data source so that it also uses Google Analytics. Now let's change the metric to engagement rate. And let's apply the Google Ads filter we just created. And now we need to do the same for the sparkline. So we change the metric. And add the filter. Now we're going to include a table that shows the different campaigns along with their associated cost and the number of conversions coming from each campaign. So let's select Add a Chart. And under Table, let's choose the option in the middle that is our table with bars. Let's change the data source to Google Ads. And let's add campaign as the dimension. And let's add cost as a metric. And let's also add conversions. Now let's select the style tab and deselect row numbers. Then we need to look for metrics. And under column number 1, let's enable show number and compact numbers and set the decimal precision to 0. We can now quickly see the associated cost and number of conversions for each of our campaigns in the dashboard. Now let's add a column chart to our dashboard. And let's change the dimension to device. Let's remove the default metrics. And let's add cost and conversions as metrics. Now let's select style and set the number of bars to 3. I'm just doing this to remove the devices that don't incur much cost. Now all we need to do is add the timeline at the bottom of our dashboard to give that detailed view for each day. This will let us see the cost and number of conversions. Let's add a combination chart to our report. And let's change the dimension from campaign to day. and change the metrics so that cost is above conversions. Now we need to change the sorting because we can see it's not actually sorting by day. So let's change the sort to day and then ascending. Now let's select style and look for series 2 and select right as the axis. Now we need to add white rectangles behind our charts. And we can also adjust the colors used for the dimensions in our dashboard. We've now built our Google Ads dashboard. We can see at the top we have top-level metrics presented as scorecards along with the spark lines for each of those metrics. We can also see a breakdown of the different campaigns with their cost and total number of conversions, plus the cost and number of conversions for the different devices people are using, as well as the timeline that shows a day-by-day breakdown of the metrics. So that's how you can create your own Google Ads dashboard in Google Data Studio. You can now customize your dashboard further. And if you'd like to get a copy of this dashboard, then I've included a link to the template in the extra resources below this video. I'd love to know if you're using Google Data Studio to report on your Google Ads campaigns. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.